So good afternoon, everyone. So as sir has introduced, I'm Shehnaz Ilyas. This has been my first attempt, and I had done it in self-preparation, and I have a 2-year-old kid. I started my preparation during my maternity leave. So there is a gap of 6 to 9 months where you do not need to report to job and your office pays for you. So I thought it's financially more viable to start it there, because you have some free time. I had my family support. I had my mother who will assist me in taking care of my child. So I thought, why not use this? Why not try to do something useful? Basically, everybody is Tamil. Okay. So, except three. You will be able to understand? Okay, fine, cool. So, basically, personality is இது வந்து பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்றதுக்கு டெசிஷன். ஸோ வாட் ஐ டிட் வாஸ், ஐ கேனாட் சிட் ஐடில், ஐ எம் தட் பர்சனாலிட்டி. ஸோ 6 மந்த்ஸ் சும்மா உட்கார்றது, ஐ வாஸ் நாட் ஓகே வித் இட். ஸோ சும்மா உட்கார்றதுக்கு பதிலாக ஃபஸ்ட்டு 2 மந்த்ஸ் டைம் இருந்துச்சு குரூப் 2க்கு, ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் எழுதலாமே, சும்மா 2 மந்த்ஸ் வந்து ஏதாச்சும் படித்து எழுதலாமேனு சொல்லிட்டு 2 மந்த்ஸ் ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணி எழுதினேன் குரூப் 2. ஐ வாஸ் 9 மந்த்ஸ் ப்ரெக்னென்ட். இன்னும் நல்லா ஞாபகம் இருக்கும், இவ்வளோ பெரிய வயிறு இருக்கும், எடுத்து போயிட்டு உட்காந்துட்டு எழுதுவேன். என்னால் 9 மந்த்ஸ் ப்ரெக்னென்ட் லேடிஸ் கேன் நாட் சிட் ஃபார் அ வெரி லாங் டைம், 2 ஹவர்ஸ். ஸோ ஃப்ளையிங் ஸ்குவாட் இல்லாத டைமில் என்னை எந்திரிச்சு வந்து ரெஸ்ட் ரூம் போகிறதுக்கெலாம் விடுவாங்க. ஸோ நான் என்ன கொஞ்சம் நிற்பேன், உட்காருவேன், அப்படி உட்காந்து தான் நான் எழுதினேன். ஐ கிளியர் குரூப் 2 கொஞ்சம் ஈஸியாக போச்சு. சரி, வை நாட் யூபிஎஸ்சி, யூ ஆல்சோ ஹாவ் 4 more months, 6 more months, சொல்லிட்டு தான் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் திஸ் யூபிஎஸ்சி. ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் ஐ ரெக்கவர்ட் ஃப்ரம் மை ப்ரெக்னன்சி, ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் மை யூபிஎஸ்சி. திஸ் இஸ் த வை ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் அண்ட் வேர் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் வென் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட். ஸோ வென் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட், ஒன் திங் ஐ டிட் வாஸ் ஐ சா லாட் ஆஃப் டாப்பர்ஸ் வீடியோஸ், ஷோர் யூ ஆல் வுட் ஹவ் சீன், அண்ட் எவ்ரிபடி வுட் ஹவ் செட் சர்டன் திங்ஸ் காமன். ஸோ வென் ஐ சோஸ் மை ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, பிகாஸ் ஐ கேனாட் கோ எனிவேர் அவுட் சைட் ஃபார் கோச்சிங் இன்ஸ்டியூட், பிகாஸ் லாஜிஸ்டிக்ஸ் ப்ராப்ளம், பிள்ளையை விட்டுட்டு போக முடியாது. நான் தான் பண்ணியாகணும், வீட்டில் தான் பண்ணியாகணும், பிள்ளை தூங்க மாதிரி வீடியோ பார்க்கலாம், புக் எடுத்து படிக்கலாம். ஸோ தட் வாஸ் மை ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, அப்படி தான் ஆரம்பித்தேன். நிறைய டாப்பர்ஸ் பார்க்க மாதிரி யூ ஹாவ் டு சூஸ் யுவர் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, யூ ஹாவ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வை அ டாப்பர் ஹேட் சோசன் தட் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, வாட் இஸ் ஹிஸ் பேக்ரவுண்ட். ஸோ வென் யூ லுக் இன் டு மை ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜிஸ், எவ்ரி திங் வில் பி டைம் கன்ஸ்ட்ரெயின்ட், மேனேஜிங் ஃபேமிலி அண்ட் மை ரிசோர்ஸஸ், ஸோ இட் வில் பி இன் தட் லேன். ஸோ வென் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அண்ட் வென் யூ லுக் இன் டு டாப்பர் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வை தே சோஸ் இட், ஸோ தட் இஸ் வை டு நாட் பிளைண்ட்லி ஃபாலோ இட் ஆர் ட்ரை டு இம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் இட். ரீசன் பண்ணுங்க, ஏன் அவங்க பண்ணாங்க, அது நமக்கு அப்ளை ஆகுமா, அது வந்து நமக்கு எப்படி மாடிஃபை பண்ணிக்கலாம் அப்படின்ற மாதிரி யோசிங்க. அண்ட் அ ஃபியூ திங்ஸ் வென் யூ சி டாப்பர் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி, இட் வில் பி வெரி சிம்பிள். டு நாட் திங்க் இட் இஸ் சிம்பிள் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் நாட் யூபிஎஸ்சி லெவல் அண்ட் இட் வில் நாட் பி ட்ரூ. சிம்பிள் திங்ஸ் ஒர்க், சிம்பிள் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி ஒர்க்ஸ். இஃப் தே ஐ டெல் யூ, ப்ரிலிம்ஸ்க்கு ஒரே ஒரு மந்த்ரா தான் இருக்கு. இட் இஸ் சம்திங் லைக் ரீட், ரிவைஸ், டெஸ்ட், அனலைசிஸ். திஸ் இஸ் மை மந்த்ரா. யூ டூ ரீடிங், தென் யூ ரிவைஸ் இட் ஒன்ஸ், ரைட் அ டெஸ்ட், அண்ட் யூ நாட் ஸ்டாப் ஆஃப்டர் ரைட்டிங் அ டெஸ்ட். யூ கெட் 80, யூ கெட் 70, யூ கெட் 60, யூ நாட் ஸ்டாப் இட் தேர். யூ சி வை ஐ காட் 80. இஃப் ஐ ஹேட் ரிட்டன் 80 questions out of which 20 or 25 is wrong, you just see why 25 went wrong. So you have this thing, you will know, right? Questions which you are 100% sure, you will categorize in one category. Question you are 50-50 sure, you will come attend it in the second round. Question where you are 75-25 sure, innumo penna vechi yosichu yosichu third round la vande eluduvinga. So you have these things. So see, when you write your mock test, அதுலயே எது ஷியூரா எழுதுனீங்க, எது வந்துட்டு 50-50 எழுதுனீங்க, எது 75-25 எழுதுனீங்கன்றது யூ ரைட் இட், புட் அ டேபிள். திஸ் ஐ யூஸ் டு ஃபாலோ. ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், யூ கோயிங் டு ரைட் லைக் திஸ், 1, 2, 3, 4 வச்சுக்கோங்க. திஸ் யூ நோ எக்ஸாக்ட்லி வாட் இஸ் த ஆன்சர், திஸ் யூ நோ இன் 50-50, செகண்ட் யூ நோ இட் இன் 75-25. ஓகே, so at the end of this, when I evaluate, I'll evaluate like this, something like this, I'll evaluate myself. At the end I used to have a table. This table will have short questions, how much I answered, for example 25 or 35 or, and then how much was right, how much was wrong, and total marks I'm whatever I'm getting. So in this way I'll do for 50-50 and 75-25. I'll see the marks here. So I'll know where my strength lies. So this is what I did in analysis. Follow this, you will understand yourself when you write an examination. You will know whether your strength is fully sure or 50-50 or 75-25. Generally, toppers used to say, based on what I had seen for my strategy, they used to say, here the accuracy should be 95, 90 plus, and here it should be 50, 60, here it 40 is all right. I would say, you can find your own magic numbers, okay? Mine was never 90 here or 95 here. Mine was 70, 70 here. So I knew my 50-50 answers were mostly right. So 70% accuracy is a good accuracy. So even though I do not get 90 here, I am able to get 70 here. So I would make sure that I attempt as much as possible in 50-50 question. My logical understanding and my logical guessing is right. So, and 75-25, you have to see how much you are right, how much you are wrong. If you are wrong, obviously you have done 75-25 to arrive on the final answer. You have done some kind of logical reasoning with yourself. Good conscience, bad conscience, ukkandhu konneram pesi idhu answer neenga mudivu pannirpinga, correct? So why did you arrive on that answer? What was the logic or knowledge that made you to answer this? Understand that, okay, so that you will know whether that logical reasoning vandhu appuram theriyum answer paathu this was senseless reasoning that you had made. Do not make it again. If you are doing it repeatedly on the same kind of question, do not answer that kind of question in your actual examination. You will know which question to attend, which question not to attend based on this kind of analysis. And inge mark indrathu paakkilla, it should never go in negative. If it goes in negative, seriously think, you are guessing a lot. So your guessing strategy is wrong. So idhudhaan vandittu prelims ku whatever I did to understand how to answer. Prelims is an art of writing and attending this question. நிறைய பேர் 12 மணி நேரம் 14 மணி நேரம் படிச்சிருப்பாங்க, ஆனாலும் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் கிளியர் ஆகாது. நிறைய பேர் வந்து ரொம்பலாம் படிச்சிருக்க மாட்டாங்க, ஒரு பேசிக்கா இந்த அவங்களுக்கு அவங்கள பத்தி தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும். அவங்க 50-50 வந்தா இப்படிதான் இருக்கணும், இப்படிதான் லாஜிக்கல் ரீசனிங் பண்ணி வரணும், இந்த மாதிரி அனலைஸ் பண்ணி அவங்க வந்து அவங்களே புரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டாங்கன்னா தே வில் ஸ்கோர் பெட்டர், இட் வில் பி ஈஸி. சம் பீப்புள் ஆர் ஏசிங் இன் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ், யூனோ 4 அட்டம்ஸ் 5 அட்டம்ஸ் ஈஸியா ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் போயிடும். Because I think that is because they know what to answer. Eppadi avanga answer pannamadhu they are doing it right abindrathu. So this is something that I would recommend you to follow. Try it and I hope it works for you like it worked for me. And this is one aspect. And like I said, revision, test and analysis. When you make an analysis, for every test, you have to make your own notes. So the notes can be subject wise. You can have, you will have your own note copy, right? In that note copy, you can put for history if you are taking notes. Behind that note, you can just, I had brought my notes. I think, 1 second. So this is my polity notes, part one. So here, this is my notes. This will be my notes. So in the back side, I'll be writing my whatever I had read in my tests. I will write it here. These are the potential questions. So your test series, your coaching center is going to give you these questions for putting it in your mock test for some reason. It might have been in some news that you would have missed. They would have seen it. They would have thought maybe a question related to this is coming. So they would have given you that question. It is a potential question. Trust me, I got some 3 to 4 questions directly from my mock. I was able to answer and I was able to recollect because for every test, I was writing this notes. So try to have this notes. In this also, it is better to write it under the same topic. If at all you're taking notes for Mughals, wherever you had made notes for Mughals, try to write it small there. So it is all in one point. Your notes now becomes more than your book. Your book doesn't have that information and your note has information more than your book. So it is more valuable than your book. So this is one more thing in analysis, I would say. And in terms of revision, your aim should be in such a way that if you are revising a subject for the first time in, say, 10 or 15 days, next time, try to reduce the time by 20 to 30 or even 40-50%. Okay, as much as possible, try to do it fast. I was able to complete a prelims entire portion inclusive of current affairs in 10 days, the entire portion. One cycle, I can do it. I can do polity in 1 day. I can do history in 3 days, inclusive of culture. Economics in 2 days. And then geography in half days, environment in half day. I used to read map daily. That you map is in the morning as you brush your teeth, just open, you see one page. Give it to your father, give it to your mother or your sister or brother. And tell them, edhaachum or edatha sollunga. When they say, I would say, idhukku idhukku mele irukku, idhukku keele irukku, idhula idhu irukku. So it is, padikkiradhu vandhu or strain illama padipinga. It's a very or long process la neenga idhu padikkalam. So this is how I approached map. As usual, I had long, big maps of India and world map in my room struck. Do not keep it for decoration. Make it your mini notes. Adhula vandhittu, if you are reading about, there is a depression region near Eritrea, right, in Africa. So there was a news during my prelims. So I used to mark it there. Whatever information I remember, kutti kutti eluduva illa sticky notes la ezhudhi, I'll stick it on top of it. So maps will not have what passes, the big political map will not have passes or it will not have the dams. So I used to have this marker and I used to mark it on top of the map itself. So I would say, do not just read or look at the map, write on top of it. When you write something, you will remember more. So that was one thing on map. And for wildlife sanctuaries, bioreserve, kutti kutti, you will have A4 size level. And Google Images, you will have these things. Stick it on top. அதுக்கு மேலே எழுதிட்டே வாங்க. ஐ ரிமெம்பர் டைகர் ரிசர்வ், டைகர் சென்சஸ் வாஸ் தேர் டியூரிங் மை பிலிம்ஸ். ஸோ டைகர் சென்சஸோட ஆல் ஆப்ஜெக்டிவ் வாஸ் தேர் இன் தட் குட்டி மேப். யார் எழுதுனா, என்னென்ன டைகர் ரிசர்வ்ல என்னென்ன டார்கெட் இருக்கு, என்னென்ன ஆர்கனைசேஷன் இருக்கு, வாட் ஆர் த டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டெக்னிக்ஸ் தட் தே யூஸ், தெர் இஸ் கேட்ச் சாம்பிள், தெர் இஸ் ஸ்பாட்டர்ஸ், சம்திங் லைக் தட், யூ ஹவ் கேமரா கேப்சர் அண்ட் தெர் இஸ் சம்திங் சிசிடிவி, சம்திங் லைக் தட் இஸ் தேர். ஸோ எவ்ரி திங் வில் பி தேர் இன் தட் மேப் இட்ஸ் தட் குட்டி A4 ஷீட். That will be stuck on the on my wardrobe. So every time I open my wardrobe, close my wardrobe, I'll have a look. So you have a pictographic memory. So use something innovative. These are the things that I try to improve my retention power and strategy for writing my prelims. This was my strategy. And when I talk about mains, I started answer writing not on the day one. It is not possible on day one. You'll have limited knowledge. I would say when you finish at least two subjects, it is a very good time to start answer writing. Do not try to write answer like a full length in the start. So I think time management was not something that I targeted before prelims. Before prelims, all I bothered about was, am I able to perceive the question? Am I able to think in different dimension? So I had about, I was dealing only about the knowledge part and the thinking part that goes into the answer. So I was able to finish 2 10 marker in 30 minutes. That is really huge. Okay, that is a long time. So I did not basically bother about time. I did not pressure myself on that. I started concentrating on time, but I kept in my mind, somehow I have to reduce it. I was 30 minutes na kadaisla 20 minutes da vande, even that is also a long time, 6 or 7 minutes more than the targeted time. So I did not bother about the time before prelims. After prelims, I concentrated on full mock tests. You will have a lot of resources where you can download the full mock papers. Take the mock papers, give full mock test every other day or once in 3 days maximum. And every week, write one full essay. By full essay, I mean 2 essays. Essay also, I started even before prelims. 6 or 7 months before prelims also, I was writing essays. Before my essay, actual main examination, I would have written some 50 to 60 essays. I was comfortable. I knew what were my strength in essays. Not everybody, you have certain categories, right? Societal, women empowerment, you have something about education, health, international relations. You'll have certain topics, broad topics. You will, if you write 50 to 60 essays, you will know which essays are your strength, where you can play your strength, and which essays, எப்படி எழுதினாலும் வராது சில essay. எனக்கு இன்டர்நேஷனல் ரிலேஷன்லாம் நான் என்னதான் எழுதினாலும் இட் வில் பி வெரி போரிங். எஸ்ஏஸ் ஹேஸ் டு பி கேப்டிவேட்டிங், இட் ஹேஸ் டு டாக் டு யுவர் இன்விஜிலேட்டர். ஸோ ஐ நியூ விச் எஸ்ஏஸ் வேர் மை ஸ்ட்ரென்த் அண்ட் இஃப் இட் இஸ் மை வீக்னஸ், ஐ நியூ வை இட் இஸ் மை வீக்னஸ். ஸோ டு நோ யுவர் ஸ்ட்ரென்த் அண்ட் வீக்னஸ், யூ ஹாவ் டு ரைட், யூ ஹாவ் டு சி டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜிஸ். எஸ்ஏக்கே நிறைய ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி இருக்கு. ஐ ஸ்கோர்ட் 140 இன் எஸ்ஏ திஸ் டைம். ஐ வுட் சே தட் இஸ் okay. This one? ஓகே தேங்க்ஸ். ஸோ எஸ்ஏ எழுதும்போது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐ யூஸ் டு ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜைஸ். ஸோ வென் யூ ஹேவ் எஸ்ஏ 3 hours, யூஸ் 15 minutes டு ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜைஸ், ஈவன் 20 minutes டு ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜைஸ் ஃபார் ஒன் எஸ்ஏ. ஸோ 15, 15, 30 minutes ஃபார் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜைசிங் இஸ் ஃபைன். ஸோ ஹவ் ஐ யூஸ் டு ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜைஸ் இஸ், இஃப் யூ ஹாவ் அன் எஸ்ஏ டாபிக், திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் டாபிக, திஸ் இஸ் மை ஆக்சுவல் எக்ஸாம்ல வாட் ஐ வில் திங்க், திஸ் வாட் எவர் ஐம் ரைட்டிங் ஹியர் ஐ வில் ரைட் இட் ஆன் மை பேப்பர் ரஃப் ஒர்க். ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி மை இன்ட்ரோ, ஒன் பேஜ். நெக்ஸ்ட் பேஜ் வாட் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃப்ரம் தட் எஸ்ஏ, தட் வில் பி த நெக்ஸ்ட் பேஜ். லாஸ்ட் வில் பி வே ஃபார்வர்ட் அண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் வில் பி கன்க்ளூஷன். ஸோ திஸ் வில் பி ஒன் சைட், திஸ் வில் பி ஒன் சைட் அண்ட் தென் யூ வில் பி லெஃப்ட் வித் 3 pages. ஸோ 3 pages ஐ டிவைட் இன் டு 3 divisions, 1, 2, சம்திங் லைக் த 3. ஸோ தீஸ் 3 ஐ வுட் பிளே இட் இன் அ வே வேர் இட் கேன் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோர் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டைமென்ஷன். If it is a climate change issues, how technologies are being used for climate change issues, if it is an agriculture, something like that, I say what is existing. I'm just guessing. It can be anyway, however you are thinking. Okay, existing. Then it can be possibility. Okay, or application. Sorry, possibility, application. Okay, and then it can be some other topic. So 3 pages will be 3 dimension. Now your essay looks structured. It has an introduction. Next side, it has an understanding. You are telling what my essay is going to contain, what I have understand by the one sentence that you are given, and what I'm going to deliver will be here in one page. This will be 1.5 or 2 or 1, something like that. I'll decide based on the contents that I think of. So here, again, I will use one more diagram. I have a matrix kind of thing. I'm not able to recollect the entire matrix currently. It will be family, region. Region is geography. Societal people, okay. And then political, cultural, something like this. So in family, I can say about I'll have three. That is a matrix, okay. Something like this. You have your own matrix. And this will be, each matrix will have subdivision. For example, if societal in people, I'll have tribes, women, specially challenged. So something like that. You will have to have your own matrix. I had my matrix like this. For every topic, I would try to think in these subheadings. So when I write my essay, it will be diversified. It will have certain amount of information with family. It will have certain amount of information with the region. So you'll have your essay as a diversified. It will look as a well-informed. Without this, or without having a practice, if you start thinking, often we tend to think in one dimension. We do not, we yosike 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 ulla poite irupinga, and nariya branch irukum, and the branch vandittu mind use pandradhukku paakanumna என்ன ஆகும், இதெல்லாம் தான் படிக்கணும், இது படிச்சாதான் உங்களுக்கு வந்துட்டு அதெல்லாம் யோசிக்கலாம். இப்ப நான் கிளைமேட் இஷ்யூ வர மாதிரி ஐ திங்க் அபவுட் ட்ரைப்ஸ். ஸோ வாட் அபவுட் ட்ரைப்ஸ் லைவ்லிஹுட், விமன் வந்துட்டு கிரைம்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்துட்டு விமனுக்கு அதிகமாகும், விமனோட பேர்டன் அதிகமாகும், தேர் ஆர் ரிப்போர்ட்ஸ் ஆன் தட். ஸோ ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் திங்கிங் அபவுட் தோஸ் ரிப்போர்ட்ஸ். ஸோ வென் யூ ஹாவ் தீஸ் திங்ஸ், வென் யூ ஹாவ் அ டாபிக், யூ வில் சி ஹவு யூ கேன் ரிலேட் இட் வித் தீஸ் திங்ஸ். ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஒன் திங். ஹாவ் யுவர் மேட்ரிக்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் page planning. So this is my strategy for essay. And you have GS, you have a standard syllabus, take your syllabus. Do not overthink. Do not make a PhD in every topic. Okay. You do not need to know every nook and corner. UPSC is simple. How much ever you are simplifying it, how much ever simplified and clear knowledge that you have, that much easy it will be for you to answer questions. For every topic, know what is the definition, know what are the basic issues with those topics. For example, if there is land, you know what kind of pollution it is there, that is associated with it, what are the kind of degradation. So there are certain issues that is related. If you are talking about civil societies or NGOs for that matter, you have the self-help groups, right? So in that issues, you will have about financial issues they have. they do not have that knowledge. They always depend on NGO. You know, you have to know the broad issues. So, and for every issues, you have to know why is it so, a basic understanding. And then what are the steps that government has done? Is there any committee or report that has said something about it? So a certain miscellaneous topic, this much is enough, and do not overthink about it. Have a 2 pages maximum notes that cover broadly these things. So எப்படி கேட்டாலும் இதுல இருந்து நீங்க ஏதாச்சும் யோசிச்சு எழுத முடியும். அது எப்படி உங்களால யோசிச்சு எழுத முடியும்னா, யூ ஹாவ் டு டூ ஆன்சர் ரைட்டிங் ப்ராக்டிஸ். ஒன்லி தென் யூ வில் பி ஏபிள் டு ஹாவ் யுவர் லிமிட்டட் ரிசோர்ஸ் அண்ட் மேக் இட் ப்ரெசென்டபிள் அண்ட் ரிலேட்டபிள் டு த க்வெஸ்சன். ஃபார் தட் இட்ஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டு ஹாவ் ஆன்சர் ரைட்டிங் ப்ராக்டிஸ். So answer writing is not only about time management. It's not about in 3 hours to fill as many words as it is required and just give the paper. You have to give a relatable answer. You have to give an answer that is asked by the examiner in the question paper. For that, you should be able to perceive the question. You should be able to understand and recollect. I have seen a lot of people who will not be able to recollect what they have read. மெயின்ஸ்ல உட்காருவாங்க, ஐ வெண்ட் பிளாங்க், ஐ ரெட் சோ மச் பட் தென் ஐ வெண்ட் பிளாங்க் சொல்லுவாங்க. தட் மைட் பி பிகாஸ் தே ஹட் ரெட் டூ மச், தே ஹட் காம்ப்ளிகேட்டட், தே ஆர் ஸ்கேர்ட் ஆஃப் யூபிஎஸ்சி. டோன்ட் பி ஸ்கேர்ட் ஆஃப் யூபிஎஸ்சி. இட்ஸ் அ வெரி சிம்பிள் ப்ராசஸ். இட்ஸ் அபவுட் யுவர் மெச்சூரிட்டி லெவல். இட்ஸ் அபவுட் ஹவு யூ டேக்கிள் அ ப்ராப்ளம். ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன் வருதா தெரியலையா, டு நாட் கெட் டென்ஸ்ட். அந்த இடத்துல நமக்கு என்னென்னலாம் அதுக்கு ரிலேட்டடாக தெரியும்னு யோசிங்க. அதுலேருந்து வரது வச்சு எதெல்லாம் இதுக்கு ரிலேட் பண்ணி இப்படி சொல்லட்டி போட முடியும்னு பாருங்க. ஸோ தட் யூ கெட் சம் மார்க் ராதர் தன் அ ஜீரோ. ஆர் இஃப் யூ கெட் டென்ஸ் மேபி 2 or 3 more questions, you will not be able to answer much. I believe 70-80% is on preparation. Balance 20-30% is on your presence of mind and your calmness and your mental state in your examination. Have a develop certain amount of calmness in you in examination. Do not be scared of UPSC. That is the first point I would like to say. So this is one thing. This is on essay. For GS, write answers a lot. புரியாத க்வெஸ்சனுக்கு எப்படி ஆன்சர் எழுதுறது, படிக்காத டாபிக்ல எப்படி வந்து மைண்ட்ல வந்து எதாச்சும் ரிலேட்டட் அப்படி வந்து யோசிக்க பாருங்க. ஏன்னா ஹவு மச் எவர் யூ ப்ராக்டிஸ் இன் த எக்ஸாமினேஷன் ஹால், தேர் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி சம் 3 or 4 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் வேர் யூ டு நாட் நோ மச், யூ ஆர் நாட் ப்ரிப்பேர்ட், யூ ஆர் அண்டர் ப்ரிப்பேர்ட். அந்த க்வெஸ்சன்ல எவ்வளோ மார்க்ஸ் எடுக்க போறீங்கன்றது தான் அங்கே வந்துட்டு கேம் சேஞ்சர். ஓகே, படித்தது எல்லாமே ஆல் ஓவர் இந்தியா ஆல்மோஸ்ட் சேம் ரிசோர்ஸ். எல்லாரும் அதே வெப்சைட் தான் பார்க்க போறாங்க, எல்லாரும் அதே புக் தான் பார்க்க போறாங்க. புக் லிஸ்ட் இஸ் நாட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட், யூ ஆர் நாட் கோயிங் டு ஹாவ் அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ரிசோர்ஸ். த சேஞ்ச் இஸ் யுவர் மென்டல் ஸ்டேட் அண்ட் ஹவ் யூ அட்டெண்ட் த க்வெஸ்சன். தட் 3 or 4 க்வெஸ்சன் வேர் நோபடி நோஸ், ஆல்மோஸ்ட் மேஜர் மெஜாரிட்டி ஆஃப் யுவர் வாட் காம்படிஷன் வில் நாட் நோ. அதுல உங்களால எப்படி வந்துட்டு சமாளிச்சு எழுத முடியுது, அங்கேதான் 1 mark மேல 4 mark மேல கீழேன்னு கொஞ்சம் போறது. ஜிஎஸ்ல ஆல்மோஸ்ட் பாத்தீங்கன்னா எல்லாருக்கும் 1 mark தான் இருக்கும். இந்த யாருக்கு அதிகமா போறதுன்னா அவங்க வந்துட்டு எதர் எக்ஸ்ட்ராஆர்டினரியா எல்லாத்தையும் ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணி வச்சிருப்பாங்க, இல்லைன்னா இந்த அளவுக்கு சமாளிக்க தெரிஞ்சவங்களா இருப்பாங்க. ஸோ நீங்க வந்துட்டு சமாளிக்க தெரியற ஒரு ஹேபிட்டை உண்டாக்கிக்கோங்க, அது வந்துட்டு லாங் வே போகும். அண்ட் அனதர் திங் இன் ஜிஎஸ்எஸ் ப்ரெசன்டேஷன், இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன், பாடி, கன்க்ளூஷன், யூ வுட் ஹவ் ஹர்ட் அபவுட் இட். So for every question you will have introduction. Introduction la major la irukum, like data points edalam, definition edalam, this part, and then you will have body, and then you will have conclusion. This was my strategy. For every topic I used to box it and give a topic. For introduction I didn't give topic. Here body will have 2 or 3 subdivision based on your question. Introduction and conclusion, do not give introduction, do not give conclusion. And here I used to draw a diagram. Whatever I understand, it will be something like this. Either indha mari irukka vaipu irukku, whatever many dimensions, or it can be a sun diagram. Not for every question you'll be able to think about a diagram. So if you know, if you can read the question and bring in dimension, you can put it in terms of sun diagram. This I used to follow, and for almost every question you have a diagram, that is sun diagram, at least you will be there. Try to bring in a diagram. If not possible, resort to this thing. So that was one thing on GS. And for interview, I associated with Shankar here in the academy. They helped me a lot. They will make you talk with a lot of bureaucrats. Very helpful. They voluntarily try to assist you. I got 173 in my interview. That's an average mark. I was predicted that I'll get 175, and I got 173. ஸோ அவங்க சொல்கிறது வந்துட்டு ஜென்யூனாக எடுத்துக்கோங்க, அது வரும்ன்றது வந்துட்டு ஐ ஹவ் சீன் வென் தே செட் 175 ஐ நியூ ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு கெட் 175. ஆல் ஐ ப்ரேட் வாஸ் ஐ டோ நாட் கோ பிலோ 170. ஸோ தே வில் அரேஞ்ச் அண்ட் ஒன் ஆன் ஒன் இன்ட்ராக்ஷன் வித் பியூரோக்ராட்ஸ். இட்ஸ் வெரி யூஸ்ஃபுல். தட் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் தட் யூ கேன் கெட் ஃபார் அன் இன்டர்வியூ. தே வில் லிசன் டு யூ, தேல் டெல் யூ திஸ் ஆர் யுவர் ஸ்ட்ரென்த்ஸ், திஸ் ஆர் யுவர் வீக்னஸ். Listen to them and take their input seriously and go back and work on it. So, and main thing is how much ever you work on it, anxiety is one thing that will beat you in your examination. You will be sitting in a waiting hall, then they'll take you to the actual boardroom, where the board sits. In front of the door, you will be made to sit for a minute or two. That is the moment you will feel all the anxiety. So there was a beautiful garden in front of me. It was, I think it was a kind of a circular or a curvature building. So there was a garden there. I had listened to a lot of toppers who said that they were very anxious. They had this fear, you will want the ground to split and take you in, and you will have all these thoughts. So I made a point that I shouldn't have any fear. I was looking into the garden. I thought I am chilled. But then inside, I had an anxiety which I did not realize. Which I realized only when the board member started asking questions. And even then, I didn't know I was in anxiety because I blabbered something. It took me some two or three questions to sink in the conversation and know that, okay, fine, I'm in interview, I can answer. So first two or three questions, it was what? When you are asleep, they wake you up and you ask something and you answer something. And just like, please let me sleep. That was my state. So it took me two or three questions to understand and come into the game. So I would, if given another chance, I would try one more strategy to not look into garden, or at least try something so that I'm alert from the very first question. So if you have an opportunity to go for interview, relax your mind. When you go there, be alert. Your alertness comes, or you begin to take the seriousness after two questions. That happened to me. Do not do it. So that was a mistake I made. I hope you do not make it. And you will have a wonderful platform and wonderful guidance there. I can talk about that because I took the guidance here. So any questions I can take, or we can wind up. Okay. I do not recollect much. As far as I recollect, I can tell you. So the essay that I took was, I took an international relation essay. I was not very good, but then I did not want to take an essay on women. I have heard some toppers who say that women, when I am a little feminist, so I'm a strong voice of women empowerment. I want some changes. So there is a bias when it comes to such topics. Some people will be for, some people will be against. So when I heard toppers say that when you write this thing, you will let the examiner know that you are a woman, or your beliefs are there. So I wanted to take a topic which is not opinionated. There was a topic on patriarchy, if I would have been comfortable, but then I made a point I shouldn't write that. I do not know if it is the same or not, but that was the reason why I took this international relation. There was one topic which said technology is something like that. Do you recollect something? Technology is the silent factor in international relation. So it was not purely international relation, it was science and tech combined. And the other essay which I took was, ship doesn't sink because of the water around it, it sinks because of the water in it. So in ship doesn't sink because of water around it, it sinks because of water in it. I do not remember the introduction I had written. I usually take a story kind of introduction. I write fiction stories, so I am confident. So I took one page. First page was, introduction story. And second page here was my understanding, what I understood. I spoke about Titanic ship. So it had been on a voyage for a very long time. People were having a very nice time. They were enjoying the view around it. It's not then that the ship sank. It was sinking only because the water came and people started panicking. They did not have hope, blah, blah, blah. I related this Titanic here. So I wrote about Titanic. And then திஸ் வாஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டூ திங்ஸ். அண்ட் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஃபியூ பேஜஸ் ஐ ரோட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அபவுட், ஐ செக்மெண்டட் இன் டு த்ரீ பார்ட்ஸ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இஸ் இந்தியா செல்ஃப் அண்ட் வேர்ல்ட். I took in two stories for India. Right after independence, entire world thought India would sink. India would last. It's a democracy where people do not have food. They fight for food. India will not be a successful country. It will again crumble. Every newspaper in the Western world was something like this. But then we did not let those views come inside our country, inside our heart. Only then we were able to sail through. So I quoted that example and I gave a few feeder points or story I spun around that. And the second was 1991, when we had this financial crisis. So I said, again, the second, it was not the first time India did, the second time, that was my connector sentence. Second time in 1991, when India was questioned, very question of India's survivability was questioned again. Again, we did not succumb. We had we saw what can be done. So then I told that we were here in this part. I said something like we were able to overcome our challenges, overcome the difficulties, because we were not letting all our issues, problem to get into us. We were sailing because we had kept the problems at bay. We were thinking about the solution. We were able to think just because we did not have this doubts or insecurities clouding us. So everybody can take a lesson from India. So something like that. And then I said, what can, from these lessons for self from India, lessons for world from India. These were my topics. Lessons for self from India, lessons for world from India. So I related these two things with a person's individuality. In life, I took three different stages or something like that. Women, tribes, I took different dimensions here, different people, and I related that, and I said how they had come up well, and how women were having social ills, they did not succumb, they had fought it because they did not let it get inside them, they did not normalize it. So that's why we had this women empowerment wave, first wave, second wave, third wave, and all we had. So those were the kind of diversification that I gave in self. And in terms of world, when it came to world, I spoke about the environment. I more or less, I kept it in a way forward manner. So I said, like, now we are in this situation where a lot of environmental issues are around us. The question of survivability of the entire earth is there. So from India, we can learn that we should not let it come inside us. It should not eat us. But then we should fight it. We should sail through it. There are solutions that is being proposed. Something like that for environment. Then I spoke about economy. I spoke about COVID. So something I spoke about environment, COVID, some three or four dimensions I gave in the world. And then in conclusion, I do not remember the conclusion. So I gave some kind of conclusion. This was my linkage. It was like a story. What India did, from India, what we can learn, what world can learn. So in world, I kept it in a form of way forward. And then I finished it with a conclusion. This was my first essay. Second essay. And I think I wrote one quote. That is something that gives you, like, you have prepared something for your essay. So introduction was a story. End, I used to write a quote. So that was my strategy for the first essay. Second essay, international relation. Again, introduction story. Second, understanding, to understand how technology has been important. What I understand from the topic, I had given an understanding. Next, here, what I quoted was the 1965 Civil War. In the Civil War, what happened was, in 1960s, there was this Cuban issue, if you can remember. So it was after the World War, the entire international relation was around the nuclear technology. So here, in the second question, my diversification was around different technologies. It was on biotechnology, it was on agriculture technology, it was on nuclear, space. So I diversified my topic based on the technologies. So you do not need to have follow the matrix strictly. If you feel that this is a kind of diversification that I can do, do it. So what I did was I took this different. First, I started with nuclear. I said like in a time scale, I kept it. So first nuclear, then I spoke about the chemical weapons and chemical things that happened. And then I spoke about the biotechnology, space technology. So when it came to nuclear, the entire civil war, the post-World War order was depending on who possessed nuclear power. So, and the civil war came to an end approximately because in Cuban issue, you have this, not, sorry, not it came to an end. There was this Cuban issue where the mere placing of a missile, nuclear missile in Cuba was a problem for US. So they had come to some kind of treaty, a backdoor treaty was there. I do not recollect currently, but I had read some story on that. So I put that story over there. And then I spoke about biotechnology. I spoke about chemical technologies, how it was used in eliminating spies. Then I said spyware, how. And then I also gave a dimension that technology is not only with the governments. Technology is also with the corporates. Now, if you are in an information technology where the international relation is not only decided by the governments, if there are few corporates whose economic potential is more than smaller countries, so they are also powerful. It is because of the information technology and the power of data that they have. So I spoke about how corporates are also playing a role in international relation because of the technological power. So these were the broadly, I do not recollect the exact chain like how I recollect here, but I quoted a lot of example. I did not give much data points. Basically, it is on your strength. If you are a good storyteller, put examples, spin a story. If you are a strong data point person, put data points, but then do not bombard with data points. They are not here for a GS answer. Understand it's an essay. Make an essay enjoyable. That's all I would like to say. Any other question? My optional is sociology. Yours is not sociology. Okay. Any other question? Yeah.
What's your daily routine?
Okay. Daily routine. 2 months before the prelims, I used to study 9 hours. 8 hours. After that is 2 months. If I have 2 months for prelims, then I used to study 10 or 12 hours. Sometimes in mains, I had gone for 14 hours. And I used to do 14 hours for 2 days or 10, 12 hours for 2 days. Third day, your eyes will become sore. I used to have this Everfresh drops. If you do not put your Everfresh drops, your eyes will be swollen. That is because of my pressure. This was my first attempt. I did not have coaching. I had, because of which I did have to push myself on certain days. Not all days you study on 14 hours. That is not possible. You are human. So 2 days you study for 14 hours. The next day you study for 8 hours. Your body will say, sleep today. Not sleep today. That's all. Listen to your body. That's very important. And my routine was morning. I used to wake up at 5. And I start reading. My daughter will wake up somewhere around 9. Before 9, I used to read as much as possible. When she wakes up, I'll go visit her. I'll make sure her breakfast is ready. So that's some time for my kid. And then I'll go back, I'll start studying. I used to study only one subject per day. I do not sandwich two or three subjects. When I go and visit my daughter, I try to club my lunchtime, breakfast time along with it. So I do not put an extra time for my personal care. I used to club it along with my personal work when I go outside to the hall. I usually sit in my room, I lock my room, and I read in my home. And very occasionally when my daughter, sometimes kids are very energetic, they'll not let you study. She'll keep coming and she'll be banging my door. That time, if I want some concentration, I used to go to study hall near Chrome Pit. There is a study hall. I used to go to the study hall. That was for a few months. Otherwise, I have this morning 5 to 9, 9 o'clock breakfast, and then 10 to 12:30, and then half an hour or 1 hour lunchtime. And then till 5 o'clock. After 5, I used to take my daughter for park or something like that. And 7 o'clock, my mother will take care again. So 7 lindu, again till 9 or 10, I'll read. 10 o'clock, she'll come back. She'll sleep with me. So this was my overall timing. And then evening, I used to write mock test. 1 month before prelims, I aligned it to the actual mock main prelims test timing. So 4 hours every day for mock. Otherwise, it is reading and revising. That's all. Okay. I had quite some time actually. I started immediately after 2019 prelims. So approximately I must be having 1 year, and ours was also postponed, right? So I had ample amount of time. I'm not able to exactly calculate, but then from July or August I started. August, I guess. Okay. I can show you my notes. So that is my notes on GST. So GST in your economics books, how many pages are there in your GS economic in your economics? GST. Still not studied. Okay, it might be some 8 pages or 9 pages. I'll be able to write the entire GST in one page. So note making is an important aspect here. So if you are writing if you're taking a note about something, write it. Okay, I can show you exactly what is there, because you'll have that's. I'll tell you what is the benefit of having a notes. In GST, it came under 101st Amendment, right? So there will be certain articles 268, 269A, 270, 279A, something. One will be CGST, one will be IGST, one will be service tax will be removed, one will be state will have the goods and service. Here you'll have GST Council. In GST Council, you will have union and states. Union you'll have 1/3. States you'll have 2/3. Then you have something like, voting power. This is the voting, I guess. Okay. Then you will have something like membership. Membership 2, here you'll have 31. Usually, Minister of Finance will be here. Here you will have Union Minister and Minister of Finance or something like that. And then you will have a quorum. Will be 3/4, I guess. Something, well, quorum is 3/4 and the election voting, I think. Voting will be some 50%. I think it's interchangeable. So this was something. This was my notes on GST. This is my exact notes, if I'm right. The top left corner, top corner, this is exactly, this is this much in my notes. So this is how you take notes. So when I see this, exactly in the same manner it would have been. So I have a pictographic memory. Am I right? So below this, I'll have function. If I say function, all I would have written there is GST slabs and tax per items, special items, something like that. So there are 5 or 6 points, this much, only this much I would have written. So when you make notes, do not write another book. Make notes so that you will know the important points. What is an important one? GST Council have 2 different things. And what is the voting power? What is the membership? So when you write, make your notes, read something and do not replicate in a verbose manner. Try to put it, if you're trying to take a class, what you'll write on your board. That is what your notes will be. So it a little bit verbose and not as verbose as your books are. So that is how I would say take your notes. Helpful? Okay. Anything else? Okay. I did not read newspaper. Okay. I tried. I thought it's a waste of time. Your coaching institutes, they spend enough time and enough resources to analyze about it, give you what is related, what is the article, what is the committee, everything. They take so much pain, and why to do double work? That was my thing. But then I followed current affairs in my own manner. I used to have this Google News. You have settings over there. Tweak your settings and you will not anymore have anything about cinemas or cars or something. You'll have about politics, you'll have about polity, you'll have about governance, you'll have about environment. And then other things, I used to follow PIB, I used to follow PRS. After every session, I will not be following it regularly. At the end of every session, PRS is a wonderful website where you can enter your filter. You'll have to read, you'll have to know thoroughly whatever bills that is being passed in your current academic, current year. If you're going to attend on 2021, the previous three sessions, you have to know what are the bills that are passed. You have to know their features about the bodies, different bodies that is related in that law, or it has been replaced, or it is already existing, something like that. So for that, PRS website is there. That in that website, you have filters. You can enter your year, and you have to, in prelims, you please bother only about the bills that is being passed by both the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. That is what I followed. Refer your resource person, your faculty. But I followed only bills that is being passed by both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. I made my own notes. I used Evernote for that, so that I had three notes for three sessions. So that is how I did my current affairs. And then I used to read the annual report about of every ministry, home ministry, not every ministry, home ministry, finance, economic survey, and then you have budget. So economic survey and budget, I used to refer to the whatever the coaching institutes release. So, and then monthly magazine, I used to give a glance. I did not make notes. I concentrated on the current affairs document that they give before your prelims. That is the concentrated prelims targeted current affairs document. Before, I used to read the document in a glance, 2 or 3 hours or 4 hours maximum. I did not spend more than that to know what is happening, or you know there is some current affairs. Apart from that, I collected my current affairs knowledge from the test series. I would have written at least 100 full mocks before my prelims. So, and I took notes for every current affairs. Science and technology, environment and current affairs, I heavily relied on this mock tests and their notes. Anything else? That's it? You can wind up. It was nice interacting with you. All the best.